about to break a story. That, well, we are worried because if this story was about any journalist, it wouldn't be a problem. We will pay them and they'll stop it. But you will know there's no amount of money that will make you drop this. So it gave me the hint that at least they give money to some people. And even before that, I have been tempted before. And when we talk about corruption in the media, I think there are two main things. One that is forced, or situations compel some people to be corrupt. And then the bigger problem is one that the journalists go out of their way to be corrupt. When Dr. Daniel Bland was speaking, he made mention of Solly. There are some media houses that do not fund their reporters. So the multimedia reporters who are here, people from the multimedia group, if they were coming here and there was no car available, whatever means they use to get to this place, when they go back, they write that I spent 20 cedis to Golden Tulip and back to the office to cover this assignment, and the money will be paid to them. So in the company I work, if somebody goes to take Solly, they will be sanctioned. So with such an arrangement, you wouldn't expect somebody to go out of their way to do it. But there are other media houses that don't even pay their reporters, and when they send them to go for stories, they don't even fund the transportation. So the temptation is so high. So that is the part I said, okay, some people are compelled by circumstances to take that Solly and live on it. But it's wrong, but they are pushed. I'm not trying to justify it.